from May 15th. Home chefs in Los Angeles will soon be able to prepare and sell food legally out of their own kitchens. Their home kitchen starting this November, as the county gave the approval Tuesday for micro-enterprise home kitchen operations. The LA County Board of Supervisors approved a permitting process that will allow home cooks and sidewalk vendors throughout the country to be able to cook safe and regulated food for the public. Let's see here. Los Angeles County becomes the 15th jurisdiction in the state to authorize MEHKOs, M-E-H-K-O, with the permitting ordinance going into effect on November 1st. So that's under the ordinance. So you're still subject to, this is Micro Enterprise Home Kitchen Operations, MEHKO, like Mecca, but MEHKO. So this is, you still have to be subject to health inspectors and, you know, it kind of reminds me, well, I'll see if I can find it, but, yeah, so what does that really mean? There's an episode of Sanford and Son that I was thinking of right now. I kind of get tired of seeing so many vendors take up so much sidewalk as their own like real estate. It's annoying. You know, it's like you're just going to set up anywhere you damn well feel like it. Now, where I used to live, about a mile and a half northwest, there's a guy that sells food out of the back of his yard. He's already doing this. Now, I'm not sure, but I think he's going to be subject to ordinance, which is fine. You have to have a permit. If you get a permit, you can do whatever you want within reason, okay? So that means you can't have rats and cockroaches and like the worst I have, if I want to, I could do it because I have ants in this condominium, but the ants are well under hand. They're well in control. Situation well in hand. So that's the thing. And it's better for them to really, it's better for people to just work at home. As long as you're not cluttering. The only thing I don't want people doing is cluttering commerce. Now, by the Pep Boys, where I used to live about 2 miles away, there's a vendor that sells food, but they would sell food like just blocking the sidewalks. It used to be clear. It used to be 7 or 8 years ago, it used to be clear of vendors. And they started then the vendors started coming around. Oh, look, space. We could sell here. Then they just started blocking the sidewalks with their stupid shit. And I'm like, I don't need this. Like, I don't need this shit. So, and if you go on, if you go to Whittier Boulevard where the Target is, you see nothing but vendors. Okay. So everybody's going to have to start pulling their weight and get those permits. But, you know, they're not going to do that. No, you can't do that. No. You got to get the fucking permits, right? I don't know if they're going to do that. So people would just sell their food wherever the fuck they want. I know that for this condo, we have a guy that just comes. We have a guy. I'm not a food truck, but more of a smaller vendor. So he just kind of comes in, sells something like this stuff you see here, and just goes out. Nobody really notices because nobody really cares if he's productive enough. But I think that's good. I know in Hollywood, they had banned people from there from selling way back in 2009, 2010, somewhere in there, that too many people were selling in Hollywood. So they banned them out. They got rid of that. Either that was Pasadena. I don't remember. Yeah. Operating in kitchens, you still have to be subject. If you got rats and mice and cockroaches, no, fuck you. You can't. That's the problem, is that some people are just too complacent. They're too complicit in how they have their bad habits. If you're picking your ass and serving food, you shouldn't be doing that. Okay, wear a mask, wear gloves when you're handling people's food. That should be common sense. But people pick their ass and scratch their heads and pick their nose and just handle the food. Eh, what does it matter? It's fine. People get all kinds of goddamn diseases anyway. So I just want to say, like, I hope this really is effective. I don't want to fearmonger the worst. I'll show you something really cool at the end. Well, I'll show you a couple of things. Oh, yeah, yeah. So this is where Sanford and Rising Sun, right? This is Pat Morita. Achoo. Gesundheit. So, yeah, this is where they try to Bubba's there. And I think Grady Wilson's there too to help out. So yeah, this is where the health inspector comes in and checks everything. So this is the first time you ever kind of see this acted out. This is 1970s, right? Early 1970s. So this is like they're trying to work from their kitchen and sell food. This is funny. But yeah, I'm hoping this really works out and doesn't blow up. My mom, like one of the jobs my mom had after McDonald's was working in a kitchen where my sisters used to go to a convent for high school. And she used to just, like, she'd work in kitchens a lot. That was my mom's expertise. Not sure she was good at it, but she worked there. There's good old Colonel Sanders there making chicken from his very expensive kitchen there. Look at that. So let's wish my Latino. I wonder if this really will benefit Latinos more than anybody else. I mean, Chicanos or. It's got to. I mean, something's got to go right. It's good chicken. You know, that's the seal of approval. You don't need much. Look at that. Is there music to this? Nope. It's all quiet. Anyway, I have one or two more videos to make.